Today we're going to talk some more about school leadership, and in this course that we're gearing toward school directors and leaders, and even instructional leaders who might be still working in the learning environment, but they have the charge of people at their department or a certain level, like the lower elementary, but they're teacher leaders. So we're looking at the issues of staff development, and one of the things that we want to talk about is when we're looking at new staff members, how do we make decisions about that?
This is a very important aspect of leadership. I know every time I applied to be a head of a school, principal or head of a school, the trustees would always bring that question up to me. They would always ask, how do you bring faculty on? How do you decide who to hire and when to fire? It was kind of cold, cut and dry kind of things. And what I always said to them, and I want to bring out now, is that in Montessori, we have to always remember that it's a way of life. It's life answering life throughout the whole relationship we have with children and also especially with each other. We can't be just focused on the children. We must also be focused on our colleagues. And that begins at the very beginning when they're entering into the school. So one of the first aspects of developing a relationship is respect, which is the realization that this person coming into the school or applying to come into the school is a person, is a wholeness, has a background but also has a purpose and a will. And we want to make sure that this person is making the right decision. It's not just my making the decision on this candidate. The candidate has to make a decision on us. It's a relationship. It's a communion. And that builds on communication. In Montessori, we have those kind of three C's. Communication is so critical in the human person life to build communion, which means a union together. And from that, you build a community where you have many together. And it all begins with communication. So when I first begin introducing myself and the school to a new candidate, faculty member, I'm keying on the fact of trying to build as much communication as possible. And I want it to be genuine and related to what's going on. In looking at the person, I want to get a sense of this man or this woman's reason for applying. What are they interested in? Why do they want to work with children? And let them freely talk about that. But then most importantly, I want them to see the school as a reality. It's not an abstraction. So the next step is to bring them around so they can observe the learning environments and the children, the Montessori way of learning that we have here in the school, the other faculty members and how they work, not as teachers but as educators, and have them have a deep observation of what the community of the school is all about. Because I want them to be making a choice. This candidate knows what she wants in her life, what she can do, what her preferences are, and she's making a very important choice. She wants to succeed. And so I want to make sure she can make a very meaningful choice by having observed the reality of the school and then be making a wise choice on that. So that's the first stage, is to go through that whole process of helping them get to know the school by observation, and then with meeting with me, asking any questions they may have so they can fully understand what they're getting into when they get into a Montessori learning environment, because frankly, it's quite different from anything else that they're used to experiencing in education. Montessori is a way of life that is quite different. It's a respect of the individual child, and they have to know that so they don't have a misfit.
What kinds of qualities have you found over the years that really make the best educator? It's not always experience.
No, it's not always experience at all, and it's not always the degrees that they have. It's a personal choice that I have to make. I used to do a lot of sailing with a little tiny sailboat that I had. I had a wooden sailboat, and I used to sail on Long Island Sound. And I would invite friends or people to come with me. But I wanted to make sure that this was a good fit. I didn't want to take someone on my sailboat with me and we go sailing for 3 or 4 hours and there'd not be compatibility. the not be. So I would try to get a sense of the who would I like to invite to be with me. That's the same thing with the school. I want to get a sense of this person's personality. Is this somebody who seems to be a person that I would like to associate with and to be with, and I think especially the children would like as well. I love children and children love me, and I have a sense of what that chemistry is all about. And so I try to discern in interviewing this person and watching this person move about the school. Do they have that kind of personal character that has integrity to it and honesty to it? There's nothing phony about it. It's kind of a genuine humanity about it, a joy about it. I look for happiness in the person. I look for a good sense of humor in the person. All those things. I used to say sometimes if I was really puzzled and couldn't make up my mind, I would give them a final test where I'd bring them home and see if my dog liked them. If my dog wagged his tail, that was a deep understanding from his instinct that this was a good person. If the dog hesitated and pulled back, there was something that I wasn't seeing, perhaps. But we have to develop this kind of discernment of what goes well in the life of children. So that basically is what I look for. Mm-hmm.
What are some of the clues that they tell you? You ask them questions about being an educator. What are some of the answers that you're looking for?
Basically, what I'm seeking is, do they really respect the child? Do they want to serve the child, respond to the child? In Montessori, the whole life of learning is about responding to the child. It's being humble. It's not being a dictator. It's not being a master of the room. It's being a gardener, is the example that Maria Montessori gave us, which is a very humble role. It's dedicated to life. It's dedicated to provision to help life develop its fullest potentials and flourish. But it's a humble life. It's one of observing and responding and not dictating. So I'm looking for someone who has that understanding already that they want to serve children. It's a servant role rather than a dictator's role, and I look for hints about that.
I know I've found that it's very important to find people who want to learn and who don't come in thinking that they know everything, even if they're Montessori certified. It's part of that humility that I'm never going to be an expert. I've always got something new to learn from the children or from new technology or new research in child development, or, you know, so that people who are excited about finding out how to better themselves.
That's a very important thing you're bringing out, Kim, and that is Dr. Montessori said that the primary thing that we have to do if we want to help the child is discover the child. And we all think we know children, but we've forgotten what it is to be a child. We've grown out of that, and we're not in the habit of understanding what it is to be a child. So to begin to be able to be of help to a child, we have to discover the reality of the child. What is the child all about? So we have to have that humility to know that we don't really know. I know Helen Parkhurst, one of the great American educators who became a Montessorian at the turn of the century. She told us when talking with us once, that it took her 7 years before she finally discovered the child. Dr. Montessori told her that you have to discover the child if you're going to be successful as a Montessori educator. And she kept thinking it would be easy to do, but it wasn't. You have to dedicate yourself to observing the child in a humble way so that you can perceive what actually is going on in this child's life. Each child is an individual and unique. That's the other problem we have, that we were taught ourselves in a learning situation that was really abstract, where we all were clones and all lined up in rows and never dealt with as individuals, but always as a group of people. Class, grade 3, open up your book. And in Montessori, it's dedicated to the reality of each individual learner. And that requires us to have that dedication to discover not the child in the abstract, but the existential child, which means this child here, this child here, this child who comes in tomorrow, that I have to be dedicated to find out who this child is. Montessori said what she was about was scientific pedagogy, which was means education that is built on discovering knowledge, new knowledge. You can base it on what you know of the child already, but you're looking at a new child every time you have a child before you. And that's the main thing that I'm looking for when I'm hiring somebody. Do they have that understanding that this is an adventure for them? This is going to be a new ball game for them, and to know and to serve the child. The other aspect you bring about is the whole new technology. The child learns in different ways today than the child learned when I was a child, and we have to respect that as well. We can't dictate to the child that this is the way you're going to learn, because that's the way I learned. The child has new avenues of experience, and we have to respect that and notice that and provide that as we go along. There are many different types of minds, as Gardner brings out in his research, that you have different kinds of mindedness in children too that we have to observe and respect. So the new faculty member has to have an understanding of that too, that there's not just one child, there are these individual children who have different abilities and different ways of going about learning, different levels of aptitude, different family lives and backgrounds, past experience, and all those things have an influence on the reality, the existential reality of this child. And I have to be dedicated to observe that.
Thank you.